All right, guys, so now it's time to do the SDR brightness testing for the Sony A90J. So what we're gonna do is show you guys we're in the Spears & Munsell UHD benchmark disc. And we're just gonna start off with SDR first and then we're gonna jump into HDR. So I'm using my Xbox One S for this so that you guys know it's very accessible. Anyone can do this. On a 2% window stimulus, our peak was 700. Now we're at 702, as you guys can clearly see right there. It's just going up and down on a variable level. We're at 704 right now, right? And nobody's moving the color meter, it's right there. 715 now, it's going up. Now that it's sitting in one spot, very, very impressive stuff. And again, nobody's touching the color meter. It's just ramping up as it sits there. So I think that is really cool. It's not dropping in brightness, it's raising in brightness. It's like becoming more potent the longer you sit on a highlight. That's absolutely incredible stuff. So yeah, very good showing for a 2% window stimulus. And I'll just call it at around, what do you say, 228? I mean, it's holding pretty well. So I think or rather 728, your stimulus is gonna be pretty high, so yeah. Very interesting stuff. Let's go to the next window stimulus. We're gonna go to our 10% window stimulus. Look at that peak, wait for it. We're at 702 so far. Now it drops, 694. Now back up to 695, 693. 691. So as you guys are watching, it goes up and down on a variable level, but I think comfortably it'll sit, let's just call the peak at 694, which is basically what it's doing right now, even though like it went up now even higher to 695, now 696. It's a really weird thing. Sony TVs actually get brighter the longer you sit on the highlight, at least for the A90J. So it's like the longer this highlight sits here, the brighter it's gonna get. Now, in a real scene, it's not going to be sitting there for that long, so it won't have the chance to ramp up. It really will just flash really quickly. And to give you an idea of what I'm talking about, I'll go back to some peak highlights here, or rather some windows that we were at. We're going just backwards. You guys can see when those windows kind of blare in there, I'll go back to the 5 or 10% window right here, and that peak, 680 when it comes in. Now 678, right? That's how these windows work. So it's very challenging to try to get this 100% accurate. I'm gonna go back here and we're gonna go back to that same 10% window so you guys can see it in real time. When you do that, the peak for that 716 and it falls off almost immediately. You see how quick it falls? So that's the hard thing. It hit 716, dropped immediately, and then it's slowly raising itself back up, but you're not gonna have the time to do that in real content, so I'll call it at 716. All right, now let's move on to our, I think after this, we're gonna be on our 25% window stimulus. We're gonna go to 25% right here. We're gonna catch that peak. 477, I think is what it was before I lost focus there. But you guys are clearly seeing 47 something, you know, 470s, 470 something for your peak, I would say, for your 25% window stimulus. After 25%, we've got a 50% window stimulus right here. We're gonna switch, wait for the peak as it measures, 345 nits. And again, we can go back just so you guys can confirm that information. We're gonna go to the 50% window stimulus right here. We're gonna smash it and go right down. So you guys can see it peaks at now 343. That's where it's at, real time. No closed door testing. So this is about what we've seen already from OLEDs. And again, this is SDR, so it makes total sense that I'm not like blown back, like, oh my God, this is the most incredible thing I've ever seen. So yeah, it totally falls in line with what I've said and what I'm seeing. SDR is not the most incredible thing I've ever seen. We're going to go to a 100% window stimulus now. Again, this is SDR going down so you guys can see it. I'll put it like that. There you go. 100% window stimulus. Bam. That peak is going to be 174, now 181. And again, no one's touching the color meter. It's right there. Then we've got this right here just working for us. And 181, that's what I'll call it at. And for anybody wondering, also, it's very important I show this off, because if I don't, I already know in the comments, people are going to be like, well, how do we know you were in vivid mode? So let's go ahead and show everybody here that we are in vivid mode. I'll zoom in for those who really want me to zoom in to show you. Zoom in some more. I'm pretty sure you can see that by now, but there it is. We are in vivid mode. All right, so in addition to showing you that I'm in vivid mode, I'll show you guys my brightness settings, my light sensor settings. So I turned off the light sensor. Nothing is going to be tampering with the performance of this TV in any way. This is just a straight up raw brightness test. There's no algorithm doing anything for lighting conditions. So that argument that I'm sure somebody was just sure they were gonna be able to type is gonna be gone immediately. Then we're gonna go into the brightness, where you can see contrast and the brightness itself, which is the OLED light, is maxed out, right? Then you guys can see down here, I've even maxed out advanced contrast enhancer to give it some extra juice and peak luminance. And if all that wasn't enough, I went into color and made sure we were rocking the coolest color temperature possible. So again, the rest of the stuff is default. So, you know, 60 color by default, live color on high by default for vivid mode. So don't dock me for any of that stuff. These aren't my settings. This is just default right now. I'm in HDR. Not HDR, I'm in SDR. And yeah, this is what it is. And the lower you go on the color temperature, the worse the peak brightness gets. So in real time, what I want to show you guys, we're going to go back. I've never actually been successful to do this without clicking on something to minimize the window. Okay, so we're going to go back to the home screen. And I love doing these tests in real time because it's a lot of fun to like scientifically show you in real time like what is actually happening. I mean, I've seen a lot of claims that this TV gets certain nit ranges, and I have not seen that myself in SDR. HDR seems pretty bright, so I can't wait to see what HDR does, but yeah, SDR is not as bright as they say it is. Okay, so you guys see the color temperature at the bottom? Okay, so it's color temperature cool. You guys know what we got for that. We're gonna switch now to neutral. Watch it drop down. 717, right? Now we're gonna go to warm. 674, right? That's warm. But what if we want to drop down again to expert one? Well, now we're at 642, 643, 641, and falling. It just continuously falls now. So once you get to the warmer color temperatures, now you really start losing peak brightness dramatically. And unlike the cooler color temperatures where it just increases and continuously raises, it just falls. And it's the weirdest thing. I've never seen anything like that, right? Expert 2, same thing. And then on, let's go back up to cool. 704. That ain't no 1300 nits. That's not 1000 nits. That's right in line with what we've seen before out of OLEDs. So again, for people trying to say that, you know, I'm, you know, just trying to hate, I can't see the positivity because I just like to be negative. No. This TV is not as bright as they said it was. And even in the cool mode, you see it drops down 694. So as thoroughly as anyone can show you the real peak brightness in real time, SDR is not hitting those 1,300 nits that we were expecting. Now, maybe that's HDR, but SDR, not doing it. All right, so I don't have time in this video to show you the SDR. I'm gonna have to unfortunately put it into the next video, but I wanna thank you guys so much for watching the number one brand in honesty. I'll get that video up after this one. And until the next video, I'll see you guys later.